As of April 9th, 2023, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the famous Fuego volcano in Guatemala, whose name justifiably translates to fire. This volcano is one of the most active in Central America and frequently produces volcano-induced Strombolian explosions with associated ash emissions, pyroclastic flues, and thrown bombs of lava, which is likely where the fire in its name likely originated from. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Vanuatu, the Ambae volcano produced a new eruption which destroyed a recently formed lake. Meanwhile, in Chile, the alert level of Laguna del Maule volcano was raised, which is known to contain more than 100 cubic kilometers of magma in various states when discussing the combination of its magma chamber and magma reservoir. And in Colombia, evacuations are underway around a section of one of the planet's historically deadliest volcanoes, Nevado del Ruiz. Despite being close to the equator, this more than 17,000 foot tall volcano, which has been erupting for much of the last decade, has a major problem. Its summit region is covered in thick glaciers. Thus, when a large volcanic eruption occurs, significant amounts of these glaciers can melt, which then, along with ash fragments, descend the river valleys adjacent to its complex via what is known as a lahar, which can destroy structures and potentially cause fatalities as far as 75 kilometers distant from its summit. In 1985, such a destructive lahar occurred where a 40-meter, 131-foot-high lahar obliterated the town of Amaro 47 kilometers distant from the volcano's summit, resulting in 25,000 fatalities. At the present, there is a danger, although it is not guaranteed, that another large volcanic eruption could occur, which could possibly generate another destructive lahar as a new batch of magma appears to be intruding into this volcano at a depth of 2 to 4 kilometers. Thus, along with the volcano's alert level being raised from yellow to orange, the government subsequently closed Los Nevados National Park until further notice, along with evacuating 40 families who live closest to the volcano. Although the number of daily seismic events has decreased since then, it is still quite elevated, meaning that a large eruption could theoretically occur in the next several days to weeks at an undetermined time. As a result, the Colombian government is in the process of evacuating a further 2,500 families, many of which are deemed to live in areas with insufficient communication equipment, meaning that if a large eruption was to occur, these areas might not receive notice in time, so they are being evacuated as a precaution. In Vanuatu, the Ambae volcano produced a new minor explosive eruption beginning on April 3, 2023, creating a moderately sized gray ash plume in addition to thermal signatures visible from satellite, marking its first eruption since the summer of 2022. For context, Ambae is a shield volcano slightly larger than the Hawaiian island of Lanai, which has two prominent rift zones. In its center is a large complex caldera with large explosion craters termed Mars generated by explosive eruptions. Recent eruptive activity has largely occurred in the center of the middle lake, which in recent years has been divided into three smaller lakes by an expanding vent. Well, due to the latest eruption, the smallest of these has completely evaporated as lava appears to have flowed into it. In the next several days to weeks, this eruption is likely to continue at a moderate intensity. Meanwhile, in Chile, the alert level was raised at the Laguna del Maule volcano, which in the last year has been the site of the third highest rate of volcanic uplift on the planet. However, do not be too alarmed, as this volcano has undergone frequent uplift cycles, with sections of the lake shoreline it is named after being uplifted by as much as 60 meters or 200 feet in the last 10,000 years. During this time, Laguna del Maule has produced 6 rhyolite eruptions. The earthquake swarm, which began on March 30, 2023, went on to involve more than 2,000 earthquakes, but, in my opinion, seems unlikely to cause an eruption anytime soon, as this volcanic complex has been highly seismically active ever since it began being monitored. With this being said, there is a 2-kilometer exclusion zone in place around an area where carbon dioxide is venting onto the surface, so please keep out of this region. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 8th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.